Hey guys, welcome to Mud Girl Pottery, episode 2, how to make the basic simple salsa bowl. Again, my name is Melanie and I own 2 pottery studios here in Madison, New Jersey and 1 in Booton. We do all age classes. We really prefer you be at least 13 when you get on the wheel, because the reason why these videos are so interesting is what we do is super hard. So we're basically asking you to do a whole bunch of really small minimal tasks to keep your hands wet, to breathe, to move your hands at the same speed of the wheel, to keep your hands attached, to keep your elbows down. But we're asking you to do all of those things at the same time. So we just find that when you're a little older, your brain can do multiple minuscule tasks all at the same time. as I said in my last video, I really enjoy teaching beginners. Last video, if you didn't see it, we just did a basic cylinder, 1 1/4 pounds. The next thing that we teach after we teach trimming and handles and all those things with mugs is bowls. Not big bowls. You're not gonna come into a studio and have never throw a pot before and just throw this giant bowl. We're gonna do 1 1/4 pounds. We kind of talk about the fact that there's several different types of bowls. There is the fruit bowl, right? Because you want it to be wide on the bottom, so you put 2 apples next to each other, because 1 apple just makes it an apple bowl. The ramen noodle soup bowl, which is gonna maintain the heat. So you want it to be narrow so that the heat can stay inside. And then sort of the flat wide bowl, which is like a salad bowl or a lobster bisque bowl, because you want the surface area to be cooler. For beginners, I find it the best to teach sort of the ice cream fruit / salsa bowl, because it's kind of close to the cylinder. What we tell people is that when you make cylinders, they tend to look like bowls, and when you finally get to bowls, they look like cylinders. So let's see what we can do here. I'm gonna go ahead and fix that so you can see it. All right. So I got 1 1/4 pounds of bowl. Like I said earlier, I'm a 4 tool person, but I do add a 5th tool to the bowl. My pin tool or needle tool, my wood tool, my wire tool, which we discussed later, a sponge tool, and then I add this little rubber rib. This is actually, I can't remember what brand it is. I think it's just standard. It's a black hard smaller rubber rib. So what it is it's beveled on one side, but it's harder than the blue one. The blue one to me is a little too soft for beginners. So again, I'm gonna start elbows into my body. Remember, you're throwing with your entire body. You're not just throwing with your hands. If you throw with your hands, basically the clay is gonna take you for a ride, and we wanna tell the clay who's boss. It's a much more graphic way of saying that, but I won't do it. So again, I lock my left elbow into my hip. Push in, but not too much where I'm pushing it off. Hold on to my thumb, but not necessarily a fist, because then we'll tend to get that sort of dip, which causes the clay to open up. And I'm gonna start to karate chop down. Remember, only on one quadrant. You're always working on just one quadrant of clay. It's not this. It's not what you saw in Ghost. It's not actually a thing. By working on one quadrant, you're actually affecting the entire piece. So I'm gonna go down, in. When I get to another video and I do larger clay, I'll talk more about coning up. But we are trying to make this as basic or as simple as we can. Eventually, if I just sit here and have my hands going in towards the center and my right hand sort of controlling the height of the mound, it'll eventually just listen to me. Slowly take my hands off, and now we have a centered piece of clay. So people will stop their wheel and they'll go, Mel, is it centered? I can't tell when the wheel's not moving. But you can tell yourself. Take your finger and just have your finger down there. If that circle looks like it's kind of not moving much, it's centered. If you close your eyes and it doesn't feel like a tire losing its air, you're centered. Your hand shouldn't be doing this. So that's how you know it's centered. So with the bowl, especially for beginners, I start with a flatter mound. I don't want them to try to just automatically go up. So if I want a bowl that's about that big, I'm gonna start with a mound that's a little flatter. So I'm just gonna start a little lower with like a hockey puck or a hamburger. And now the difference between opening up a bowl and a cylinder is with a bowl, we opened it up so the inside looked like this. But now we're gonna open it up where the inside sort of looks like this. And we're insinuating a bowl on the inside, but our outside still looks like a cylinder. So in the beginning, we're just gonna whisper, bowl. So I go in there, wheel going super fast again, 2 fingers this time, and I'm gonna lean my thumbs down a little bit. By leaning my thumb down, this right here will help to create that sort of slope that we're aiming for. Go ahead and stop my wheel. Stick my pin tool down. That is a good height. That gives me enough room for a foot and my wall. And now, instead of pulling straight towards me and out and up, I'm gonna pull straight towards me and scoop a little. So here's room for my ice cream, which goes straight. And now I'm just gonna scoop up just a little bit. Gonna compress my floor with the sponge. You don't gotta keep going back and forth, and you don't wanna dig. Just wanna gently glide from the center to the end. Let me show you guys what the bottom of this looks like. So you see, it already kind of looks like a bowl on the inside, but the outside still is cylindrical. Okay, so now it's time to pull my walls. So my wheels were going super fast before. Now, most important is that you slow your wheel down. If you keep on going, then your clay is gonna go bowl really fast, and we want it to just whisper bowl. Again, finger taco. And now before, when we pulled our cylinder, we went straight up. We even kind of went a little volcano. Now I want to pull up, but I'm going to put a little bit more pressure on my inside hand. And we're just going to insinuate bowl. We're like, bowl. Start all the way flat on the wheel, so you're going across and up. Hang out down on the bottom. This hand is just floating inside. It's not pushing. It's waiting for my outside hand to sort of catch up with that inside hand. With every rotation, I go up just a little bit. I'm gonna go all the way up until my fingers meet at the top, but I don't wanna pinch my lip. With a bowl, it's super important that you keep your lip thick for several reasons. Eventually, we're gonna yell bowl, and we're gonna really make it into a bowl. And if this is a half inch thick, when we stretch it out, it'll be a quarter of an inch. If it's a quarter of an inch now, when we stretch it out, it's gonna be an eighth of an inch. And again, thin lips usually tend to chip. So I'm gonna start to pull straight forward and up. And now I'm gonna go bowl a little louder. Hands attached. What I tend to do with bowls, I tend to look over here. If I look over here, I can see what's kind of going on over here. It's a weird science thing, but it's a thing. Go ahead and compress that lip. And now I'm gonna start to insinuate bowl a little bit more. Remember, your main goal is to get your walls the desired thickness before you shape it. All the way up. Compress my lip. So now after three pulls, I feel that it's time to yell bowl. I'm time to really make it into a bowl and then call it a pot. The centripetal force really wants it to be a bowl a little sooner than you may want it to be a bowl. So you've got to really always make sure that you're always pinching, pulling your wall, but going up at the same time. And again, that thicker lip is actually going to give you a better aesthetic feel to what your bowl is. So now that it's time to yell bowl, we're going to do a shaping bowl. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put more pressure on my inside hand. My outside hand is going to just support it with a sponge, and it's just kind of guiding to go all the way around. Now this is one way to yell bowl. So I'm going to start down on the bottom, wheel going never too slow. You want to be able to know that your hands are going to go fast enough to really kind of get that bowl. Oh, we have a little bit of a wobble there. And that's why I'm going to show you the second way, which I prefer better. So then instead, we can go ahead and use this rubber rib. So you're going to hold it where the bevel is towards you. Hold it firm with your left hand if you're a righty. And I'm going to start to stretch. This may not work. And I'm gonna start to pull it all the way down. And I'm putting a lot of pressure on my inside hand until I reach the bottom. And then I'll go from the bottom up. I'm gonna do another video of common mistakes that potters make, especially beginners. I'll talk about why in that video, why I go from the top to the bottom. Yeah, this ain't gonna make it. All right, guys, so guess what? At one point, even people have been doing this for 25 years, they screw up. So I'm just gonna actually call it. A lot of my potters at this point will take this off and go, all right, what can I make this into? I don't believe in that. That's where I'm a little snobby. I'm actually just gonna take this off and name this video the Bowl Flop. So I hope you see what I did wrong. So what I did wrong is I got a little too thin down on the bottom part. Then my wheel was going a little too slow. So what happened was that centripetal force kind of made it want to go. I'm also dealing with super soft clay that I've just recently started using. I probably should have let it dry a little bit longer. So guess what, guys? 20 some odd years of experience and we still mess up. So keep practicing and enjoy your flops. It's just kind of how it goes. We'll see you next time. I will redo this bowl video, but I'm going to leave this one. So see you later.